In this presentation, we are going to continue talking about some basic concepts, an introductory concept this time, to learn about how we know about genetic variation. And the first thing to mention probably is the Human Genome Project. This was a huge international project, probably still the largest collaborative biological project ever, that wanted to sequence and map the human genome, all of our genes. It started in 1990 formally, and it was declared complete in 2003. And I still remember the biology teacher when I was in high school coming with the newspaper and saying how important it was that we could look at our DNA, and it has indeed changed the way in which we do biology and other sciences. And this has been the basic project that has been the baseline for many others, like ENCODE. So for example, while the Human Genome Project wanted to sequence the DNA, the ENCODE project wanted to interpret this sequence. And since then also, there has been a series of other projects to build what we call reference panels. And this is what I'm gonna focus in the next few minutes. So reference panels are databases that contain information about genotypes, haplotypes in a set of individuals. So remember, a haplotype is a particular combination of alleles along a chromosome that tend to be inherited together. Reference panels then are an important resource of sequence variation. They are very useful for processes like imputation. They contain a lot of information about differences in linkage disequilibrium or allele frequencies in populations. These things have happened because of mutation or historical recombination, in different circumstances like bottlenecks, foundry effects, and so on. You will also hear more about this. And also, just remember, when we say linked disequilibrium or LD, we are talking about the fact that individuals who carry a particular SNP allele at one site often carry specific alleles at other nearby variant sites. So is these correlations what we call linkage disequilibrium? And here on the right-hand side, you can see some early work showing the comparison of LD and recombination for a region in three different sets of individuals from different populations. You may have heard about the HapMap project. This is a reference panel that wanted to characterize where the LD blocks are. And it got to describe common patterns of genetic variations among 270 participants from four samples. It got to produce genotypes for 3 million SNPs. And you can see here also in the photo, in the image, the blocks in the genetic profile of three different populations that participated in this project. It was followed by the 1000 Genome Project. This project had also several phases, a pilot, and then phase one released in 2012, and another phase three released in 2015. This project wanted to find 90% of common variants. So it got also to look at a broader set of individuals of different continental backgrounds. It included 1 to 2,000 individuals, and got to get the information of 88 million variant sites with SNP frequencies that go down to 1% and also includes indels. The Haplotype Reference Consortium, or HRC, it had two releases, the last one in 2016. It includes information of more than 38,000 individuals, mainly from European ancestry, although because this project also includes the information coming from the HapMap, it also includes some other ancestries. But it reports around 40 million variants with a minor allele frequency that goes down to 0.1%. However, it does not include indels. And the last reference panel that I wanted to mention is the Transomics for Precision Medicine, or TOPMED panel. This is a program that has focused on whole genome sequencing of individuals and has included over 155,000 so far. And 60% of them are predominantly of non-European ancestry. Thanks to this project, we have information about over 780 million SNPs and 62 million indels. And if we combine all this information, we can go down to frequencies of 0.01%. You will also hear about population-specific reference panels, and you will also learn more about these in other sessions. But I wanted also to touch on another concept that is related to a reference panel. Remember, reference panel is all of these releases, HapMap, 1000 Genome, and so on. An assembly or build makes reference to data sets that include information about SNPs, where they are in the chromosomes, and in which base pairs. So you will see SNPs represented with an RS number. This makes reference to reference SNP cluster ID. And it just tells you where each SNP is. You can play with that, and you can visualize the genome in resources like the one provided by the UCSC genome browser that you can see here in the screen. But a note on this is that, of course, the more we investigate and the more we know about SNPs, the more refined we can be about where they are. So there are different releases of these assemblies or builds. And it gets a little bit more complicated because there are two main systems. The first 10 releases of these assemblies were released by the UCSC. And then this work was taken over more by the NCBI. So in the end, we have like a system with HG whatever number, and then the different builds that the Human Reference Assembly has been releasing. So we have, for example, one of the main ones is the build 37, that is called also HG19. These are talking about the same sequence. They are just different annotations to talk about the same. It is, however, something important because the more, as I said, the more we know, the more we update this. So while most of the current work probably is done in the build 37, the build 38 has been available for a while. So more and more groups are moving to that build when they work with their genetic analysis. And it is very important also because if we are working just in our group, we know where our SNPs are according to which assembly. However, if we want to do analysis like a meta-analysis, we need to know the other groups, what system they were using, because if we want to combine the information, we can easily have a SNP that in one build is in one chromosome and base pair, but it has moved in the following build. So something to check and something we will be also working on in the practical.